think so. Well, Barb has us missing one other lump there. Well, let's do this one anyway. Yep. Sounds good.
There's more surf grass along here than we've seen.
Okay.
That would be a true Halistachian band. In the mid-intertidal here, bleached rands, stock. Oh, look at that surf grass. Wow.
Yeah, very wide rock platform here.
25.
Intertidal zone.
Near shore.
And
near
there's a bit of dusting, the biogenic sand,
surf grass.
Away from the
there's
upper intertidal to the lower intertidal here.
Podium, laminarians in the lower, laria, wow, really lush, 26, podium, laminarians, macrocystis, laria, surf grass, that's all in the lower intertidal, the upper one-third is fucus, and it looks like iridia as well, the iridia cornucopia is a few patches. Places 27 out here, higher wave exposure. It's all nereocystis, laminary cicelli, coralline rads, really wide splash zone. Pretty nice barnacle band, no fucus there. And as soon as we come around into the lee over here, there's lots
again,
of mucus,
the other side of
lots
this,
of diversity in the mid-intertidal,
sand, a bit of
incredible
cobble.
Frostings of barnacles, nearshore urchins, surf grass,
incredibly rich
malaria,
algae zone in the
codium.
Lower portion of the intertidal on the bedrock platforms.
Wow.
Gray zone right in the image.
29.
Here, probably 30 meters in
width. Nereocystis,
good
surf
shot
grass,
of the cross-shore
malaria.
Biology. Okay, we got a couple little islets just behind us. Those two little guys in there? No, I don't think so. This is our first time to this little group here.
Incredible surf grass. Oh, a seal or two that didn't go in the water. Lots of fucus across the platform here. Oh, 32.
There's a whole multitude of offshore reefs, intertidal reefs here. A couple of islets with trees
incredibly
on them.
Lush.
Pretty much devoid of sediment
near
other than a dusting
and
of biogenic
very
sand.
Very thick urchin barrens here. There's a sargassum at the waterline with alaria and some other blade browns. And then the fucus band is sparse on the outside
and
dense on the inside.
In the, subtitle
33. Some kind of
so I think
red.
We're pretty much
seen
done with the tree knot group here, Mark. I guess
lots
we
of podium.
Can head north to Melville. Yeah. Is that your guess, Barb? Pause our recorders here.
A little bit of macrocystis in here.
Yeah.
And the lights
otherwise
changed.
Otherwise, I can't get it all in.
Village site.
So we've got that biogenic sand, upper intertidal, boulder cobble down below that, and then it
fins
out to just a rock platform.
Wide Neriocystis bed, really thick. Photo 34 here. Laminarins at the waterline with codium. This is Macrocystis in the inside. And then across the platform is mucus and
some biogenic sand in the subtitle. Again, another what looks like could be bit material.
Photo 35.
On the beach there, it's all shell hash.
Wow. Sure looks like a big village site. Incredible platform. This across the platform. Out on the exposed side here, it's Laminaria's Celli at the waterline. Still some malaria. And then the upper two-thirds is dominated by barnacle out here.
Let's go down this passage in between these two islands here. So fly this one. Yeah, down in there. You need to put your mic closer.
Mucus.
Jackal button. Yeah.
Surf grass looking kind of eroded down in the...
Yeah, it's an incredibly complex area with reefs and sediment. Lots of variation in the wave exposure in through here.
There's eelgrass up on the flats there.
Yeah, you can fly just a little bit. It's through there. Yeah, exactly.
37.
Perfect.
Wow.
There's a whole series of tidal flats in the lower half of the intertidal.
So,
mostly the
eelgrass.
Ramps with a veneer boulder
inside this
in the
lagoon.
Upper intertidal. Not too much sand coming
lots
right up
of,
to
mucus.
The tree line. There is some wetlands in here, so a little bit of grass area down below the tree line.
So
there's one pocket in there.
Yeah, this
another
is
pocket way
patchy eelgrass
side.
Throughout on the flats here. Incredible, even mark elevation.
If we can slide sort of to the. To the left.
Oh dear. 36.
I get my rights and lefts mixed up, but to the left and then. No, we can go, now you can turn to the right and I'll get all of this shoreline here.
Loading roll 36.
And there we've got pebble cobble, about 5 meters in width in the upper intertidal, and then a platform
near
in
shore.
The lower portion of the intertidal.
Macrocystis.
Here we've got a sand beach grading over
nope,
on the right.
Nope, it's all macrocystis here. It looks fairly a little bit eroded also. Incredible frosting of barnacles. Not much mucus in here. 36, number one. Out to the stock ground at the waterline around the corner here, near shore, Neriocystis. Water is not very clear. Surf grass at the waterline, patchy. Neriocystis, Laminaria's Celli and Elaria at the waterline.
And this is
the
intermittent
there,
cobble veneer over the bedrock
and incredible thick
lots of log debris
barnacle frosting
down today because of the really high tides. All scattered across
really
the
color of the barnacle.
Bizarre.
Photo 2.
Usually you don't see that much out here.
Laminaria's Celli and surfgrass at the waterline with codium.
So this is good market. We can fly through here and then after we get through a little way just do a counterclockwise
barons.
Turn and then we'll get the other side of this island off to
lots
our right.
Lots of codium there. Mixture of macro and neurio. There's the hedophyllum type at the waterline. Macrocystis. Photo 3. Alva, Zostra, Sargassum there. Sargassum fronds with Macrocystis might show up in photo 4.
Again, the drift logs are all willy-nilly scattered all over the shoreline, I guess because we've had high tides and not much wind.